Hi, I'm Dr. K. L. M. Rao, Director of Pediatric Surgery at Parthipis Hospital, Panchkula. Today, in the favor of public interest, I shall discuss one information on a common childhood disease. It's called as swelling or obstruction of the kidney or hydronephrosis, and technically it's called as a UPGA obstruction or uretropelvic junction obstruction. It's a very common disease in children and a very common cause of kidney failure also sometimes if untreated and left as such. Now, the kidney obstructions are one of the common diseases that occur in children, which is often undergrounds for long length of time, and even the babies in utero also can be known to be having this kidney obstructions in about 2% of the cases. Previous era, we used to diagnose the cases very late when the baby or a child has developed a big swelling in the tummy, or the pain, child started complaining of pain in the abdomen, or the baby has developed urinary tract infections, etc. It's a very late disease. Whereas now the ultrasonography has made us made things so easy to diagnose the size of the kidney obstructions and how much damage has occurred, etc. Now, as I already said, that babies in utero or in the womb itself can be diagnosed to be having obstruction, and if the size of the kidney or pelvis is more than 10 to 20 millimeters of size, then we know that in all probability the baby may be having obstruction to the kidney and may require surgery subsequently. And as soon as the baby is born, we can always investigate for the cause of kidney obstruction, and if there is one, it requires to be operated as early as possible. And the size of the pelvis has got various implications, etc. If it is less than 10 millimeters, we try to observe and watch. If it is more than 20 millimeters, we try to operate as early as we can. And between 10 and 20 millimeters of the size of the pelvis of the kidney, we can wait and watch and observe further, etc. Now, what investigations are available at this era for us to diagnose a child who is suffering with kidney obstruction? Now, we have, apart from the simple ultrasonography, we have a nuclear medicine scans in terms of a DTP scan or EC scan, etc., or even Michelin cystotherapy, wherein we put in a little bit of a contrast medium into the bladder and see if the dye is going upwards, etc., to diagnose and differentiate between obstruction versus other diseases which are also equally common in this particular age group. And then once a child is diagnosed with uretropelvic junction obstruction, when should it be operated? Once an obstruction is clearly diagnosed on nuclear medicine scans, etc., the surgery should be done as early as possible in order to prevent any further damage to the kidney. And we have good techniques available to take care of the obstructing segments and remove and bypass the obstruction and produce normal flow so that the kidney can grow normally and the child can have perfectly normal life. What is the prognosis when a child is having uretropelvic junction obstruction? If untreated, kidney would continuously go on to get damaged and kidney would be knocked out. Whereas if the operation is done and obstruction is removed perfectly, the baby can have a perfectly normal life for the next 70 to 80 years of life, etc. And of course, for a while, we will investigate subsequently also that the passage is perfectly patent and see to it that nothing else is amiss, and with that the baby should have perfectly normal life with even kidney obstruction, the so-called UPGA obstruction, hydronephrosis. Thank you so much.